I said goodbye to that plain little mining town with just a few old clothes that made the round. I knew I was leaving a lot of things that were good.
Well, I was born in Mercer County, West Virginia. I was one of 11 children. It was five girls and six boys. I was born towards the end, when my mother had already had a full family by the time the last three or four of us came along. There was always music around. People sang a lot more for their own pleasure and to entertain themselves, because there really was not a lot of places to go to where you could hear the music. And you had to travel maybe a long distance. So there was a lot of getting together at neighbors' houses or them coming to your house. My father, a lot of times at the gatherings at the house after church, they would be singing, and at some point, many times I remember he would say, "You should hear my daughter Hazel sing." And I would have to stand up in front of this crowd of people in there and sing. And maybe that's how I got started, was by his suggesting that I stand up and sing for all these people. I'm that may be where I got the bug, I don't know.
I'm making my living by the sweat of my brow. I couldn't be crooked, 'cause I don't know how.
I left home when I was 16, and I had to wait till I was 17 to get a job. And I bought a used guitar, almost out of my first paycheck. I stayed 3 or 4 years, and I left to go play music. And they sent me a telegram that either I come back or they fire me. And so I didn't go back. I went ahead and did that next weekend of work, went up into New Jersey, and they sent me my notice. We started playing in some of the seedy bars around, and I like to say that I told my mother they were clubs. Sounded a little bit better. After we got rehearsed a lot more, we got in the Pike County Boys. That was a smoother band. I had gone out and got myself a couple of these cowgirl shirts with the little bow ties and some pants to match, trying to look the part. To meet people who were interested in the music and who look at it like an art form, we had never seen any or heard of anything like that. In fact, we didn't think the music was really worth all that much. It was all new to us. In a sense, it gave me a whole different perspective on what I could be, I could become, what my music could become.
One day a mother came to a prison to see an erring but precious son.
We got together at a party and began singing, and we found that our voices matched. Actually, they matched better than my singing with a lot of men. And most of the women singers that I had known, like Wilma Lee or Molly O'Day, the women led and the men would sing just below them. But we did it like the males were singing, where she'd sang lead and I sang tenor above her.
We read in the paper and the radio tell us to raise our children to be miners as well. Tell them how safe the mines are today, and to be like daddy, bring home a big pay.
I never thought of myself as a writer. And I remember seeing it in print once, and I thought, my goodness, I'm a writer. Someone said, I'm a writer, so I must be a writer.
Remember the disaster at the Mannington Mine.
I began writing like two kinds of songs. I wrote some that were political, and I wrote some that were more traditional. And that way I could satisfy everybody, and also satisfy both sides of myself. And I really didn't realize it was coming out of me until I saw it on paper. I was learning about my own self and what was inside because I had never had an opportunity to express myself. And so I didn't know what was in there.
It takes a long time to get the feel of writing a song, you know, and putting it to music and getting down what you really want to say. And I think it's sort of like a painting. You never really do get it as perfect as you want it.
He's had more hard luck than most men could stand. The mines was his first love, but never his friend. He's lived a hard life, and hard he'll die. Black lungs.
It was very astounding to me to learn later on, after I got away from home, I left when I was 16 to go to work, that one of my brothers, my oldest brother, had lived his entire life and never got any further than he did when he first started out as a teenager in the mines. And he lived his whole life, had six children, and he died with not enough to even bury himself. And we had to go to the welfare to get enough to bury him. It just seemed like that in a country like this, that people shouldn't have to live and be buried as poor as when they came into the world. And that was the first that I began questioning the way the economy is in this world and the way that poor people are treated. This is the song that I wrote for my brother so that he would have some kind of a voice in this world.
Down in the poorhouse on starvation's plan, where pride is a stranger and doomed is a man, his soul full of coal dust till his body's decayed, and everyone but black lungs done turned him away. I got the early Monday morning working blues. I put on my ragged, worn-out working shoes.
The first job I got was in a factory, and I worked about three factories. And then I got a job as a waitress, and then I went into sales work.
Having gone out into the world and getting into the workforce myself, I began to see how that working class people were exploited, and that here I am out there and I'm one of them now. It just made me have a whole different view of what working people had to go through. I looked back then on my people and what they had come from and how hard they had worked all their lives. And then I looked at the ones that had left to find a better way of life. And I didn't see that they had any pot of gold, you know, at the end of that rainbow that they thought that they were going to find. They still had to work just as hard, even though they were in the city. Observing all this, I just always had a lot of sympathy, a lot of compassion for working people. I think it was natural that I began writing about it.
You know, we really, I think we all go through life, and I doubt that we ever know who we really are or what all we have inside. And we just have to, at some point, get to the point where that you can let go and let go enough that that you give something back to the world, or you end up, you can tell somebody exactly how you feel.
It's hard to tell.